In this video, we're going to look at characteristics of the green algae. These are a sister group to plants, and their relationships are also fairly unresolved still right now. The last big paper I looked at had them separated out into chlorophytes and streptophytes, and the streptophyte part of the green algae can't actually be separated away from the plants because land plants form this monophyletic group, so they all derive from the same common ancestor as these streptophyte green algae. Let's look at their body plan. So body plans, because we have multicellularity evolving many times, they can be unicellular to multicellular. Their environment, green algae live almost everywhere, so they can be freshwater, marine, and terrestrial. Many different species in many different places. They even live in some hot pools. So the enzyme that we use to replicate DNA and PCR, we use it because it's from this green algae, Thermus aquaticus, that has evolved to live in very hot conditions. So its enzymes still function in those hot conditions. So we can cause DNA to break apart by raising the temperature, but normally that would destroy our DNA replication enzymes. So instead, they took this DNA replication enzyme from a species that was evolved for very hot conditions. So that's how we can replicate DNA with PCR. Pretty cool. Photosynthetic pigments, we have chlorophyll A still. All of our organisms that are photosynthesizing will have chlorophyll A. But now we have a new chlorophyll, chlorophyll B, and we also have carotenoids. And those carotenoids are going to allow green algae to live in more intense sunlight conditions. And so these are the same pigments that we'll see in land plants. Our storage carbohydrate is starch inside plastids, just like plants. Their cell walls contain cellulose, just like plants. You can see why they can't really be separated out from plants. Life cycle wise, here's where they get a bit different. They have a few different life cycles. The ones we're going to look at are haplontic, but we'll also see alternation of generations in marine species. Not all marine species, but many marine species. So here's a review of that last slide for you to take notes if you need to. Here's some pictures of some green algae. So we have on the left Spirogyra, that is a unicellular green algae that forms these filamentous colonies. So each of these is an individual, but then it's forming in these colonies. And it's called Spirogyra because of these spirally chloroplasts that it has. On the right is a multicellular green algae, that's sea lettuce or ulva. We're going to learn the Spirogyra life cycle. Put meiosis over here. Fertilization over here. And I've left myself more room on top because it's a haplontic life cycle, so it's primarily haploid. So we will have meiosis, which will form these haploid cells that I'm going to draw. As these little cubes, so we have these rectangular cells that have spiral chloroplasts inside, and those will replicate to make filamentous colonies. So they don't really grow as a spore would because they're unicellular. But they're dividing by mitosis, doing asexual reproduction to make more of themselves. So this is a haploid cell, and this is a colony. So when that colony comes in contact with a colony of a complementary mating type, they will start to grow toward each other and form these tubes. And if they're lined up, ideally, each cell in the colony will get to interact with a cell from the other colony. So that tube is called a conjugation tube. When they form, one of those colonies, and I don't know if it always has to be just from one side to the other, but the contents from this one on the right is going to start to get deposited into the one on the left. So all of the cellular contents from this one colony is getting deposited through the conjugation tube into the cells of this other colony. And that is when fertilization is going to happen. So we'll have an empty colony on the right. And then on the left, we'll get these big green egg-like structures. They have thick walls and they are adapted to survive. So these big thick-walled spores are our zygotes. So these are diploid. So because we're in a haplontic life cycle, our zygote is going to be the only diploid cell that is going to do meiosis to make haploid cells. And that is our Spirogyra life cycle. So here we see some filaments of Spirogyra. On the top, we see a haploid colony that has not fused together. So we see those spiral chloroplasts. And then on the bottom, we see two haploid colonies that did fuse together. Unfortunately, this one right here did not get to mate. But the other two each formed diploid zygotes. And so those diploid zygotes are then going to either rest and wait for ideal conditions, or if they're in ideal conditions, then they'll undergo meiosis and start a new colony. Green algae are really cool. It's unfortunate we're not going to be looking at them together in lab. We often get a lot of diversity that we get to see. So there's unicellular forms here on the left side. These are chlamydomonas. They have this little eye spot and two flagella, but those flagella are whiplash flagella, notably not heterokont flagella. You can also get unicellular colonial, like our Spirogyra. So these are colonies. On the top we have volvox, and so that is a bunch of little unicellular green algae that are all beating their flagella in tandem to make this ball. And then inside of that, they reproduce other smaller colonies that will then get released and grow and be a new colony. So they're like these little hamster balls out there rolling around in the ocean. Actually, I don't know if they're marine or freshwater. I think they're actually freshwater. And then below that, I think it's pediastrum, makes these interesting, complicated, pointy, flat colonies. And then our other option here, kind of the most complex option, you can have multicellular green algae. And this one, Cara. So these are very plant-like, complex structures, branching, a lot in common with plants. So instead of having that kind of flat thallus that we saw for ulva, sea lettuce, this one is much more plant-like.